game with Pendleton. The Sports Watch computer has been working on it. It says Ashland by 3 touchdowns over the Buckaroos. At Spiegelberg Stadium, North Medford will host David Douglas. Let's face it.
Line against the Buckaroos of Pendleton. And they were hungry this afternoon for yet another win at Walter A. Phillips Field. And they would chow down against the Buckaroos. Up 7-0 in the first, the Grizzlies would score in their first 4 possessions. Jeremy Steinman to Mika Wolf, 26 yards. That will set up the second score for Ashland. The name you love to say, David Buchenugan, 2 yards around right end. Grizzlies up 14-0. Then the Ashland defense comes up big. Todd Coffey with the pickoff. And you know Ashland would capitalize. Let's say it together phonetically. Buchenugan. Good, very good. 73 yards. Ashland beats those Buckaroos 42-18. Ashland has now won 62 of their last 67 games. They're 12-0. Next week they'll be facing another 12-0 team. We'll talk about that in a second. Keeping score at home, that's 1 Southern Oregon Conference team in the semifinals. On the Grants Pass now, where they were looking to club their way into the semifinals for the first time since 1979. They obviously didn't get their fill of Thanksgiving turkey because they feasted on the Canby Cougars today. Big football now.
That leaves the Grizzlies, who hope to keep the faith when they take the field this Saturday. John Bon Jovi obviously rooting for the Grizzlies tomorrow, and that takes us to another exciting action-filled trivia question. The Sports Watch computer ready for another question. Good, it's been running on empty lately. Question number 13, since you're keeping track at home. Ashland meets second-ranked Centennial tomorrow. Who won the last time that Ashland and Centennial played? This is kind of a tricky question because the answer is, I think it's thinking nobody. The two teams have never played. That's awful. The Sports Watch computer trying to trick us. The
playoffs, the Ashland Grizzlies are rarely the odd man out. In fact, they're the odd man in, winning state titles in 89 and 91, and now looking to add 93. To have a shot at the championship, the undefeated Grizzlies, they'd have to beat undefeated Centennial. The Sports Watch's Jim Hobbs has the story.
Game one didn't have the last-minute dramatics of game two, but it was a tale of two halves. Top-ranked Ashland came out flat, and Centennial capitalized. Quarterback Jesse Brand finds Chris Berg for the 15-yard touchdown strike. Eagles up 8-0 in the second. Casey Curtis cuts the lead to 2 when he finds the end zone from 3 yards out, but it's Brand again to Micah Denna, 73 yards. The Eagles led 14-6 at the half, leaving Ashland to wonder what happened the first 24 minutes.
We said we played horrible, worst half of football we've played all year, and we're only down by 8 points or something, so we thought, you know, we knew we were going to win.
Ashland did trail by 8, 14-6 at the half, but for some reason, the school didn't seem too down because the spirit was still there. The second half saw the Grizzlies growl their way to 5 touchdowns on their first 5 possessions. Casey Curtis from 22 yards out, Grizz down 6. David Bukhanuggan from 2 yards away, Grizz up 1, their first lead of the game. Steinman to Bukhanuggan, 43 yards, Ashland up by 8. Steinman again to Bukhanuggan, this time from 32 yards away, Grizz up by 15, and finally Steinman to Micah Wolf, 36 straight points for Ashland, and that gives them an easy 42-26 win and a shot at a third state title.
We told them, hey, you can't replay the first half. That's history. It's in the book. You have no control over that, but you do have control over what's going to happen in the second half. You know that you're a better football team than we showed in the first half. We've been behind before. We've been in front before. But the bottom line is we know how to win. In Eugene-